Hello everyone. In the process of learning a subject, the most important and first step is to read the lesson, isn't it? In school, teacher makes us to read the lesson once before explaining. But at home, for the students who find it difficult to read the lesson and for the differently abled, we are introducing audio textbooks. These will help you to listen and read the lesson while going through the text. Our state government has provided us with PDF of the textbooks. So let us start reading the lesson. The seventh chapter in our English textbook is P.T. Usha, The Golden Girl. Let us start reading the lesson. P.T. Usha, India. This was the address on a letter from the Middle East. The letter was delivered by the postal department with no delay whatsoever. This was the status of Pillavulakandi Tekkeparambil Usha, who was born as the second daughter of Paital and Lakshmi Amma on 20th May 1964 in the village of Payoli, Kozhikode district, Kerala. It was November 1973 when a dedicated physical education teacher called Balakrishnan discovered Usha while conversing with a parent. His eyes, ever watchful, kept drifting to a group of small girls playing blind man's buff just across the field. Was there a pair of feet that were moving extraordinarily fast? Was that tiny dark girl in her blue skirt and white blouse moving like an instinctive athlete? Patient as ever, Balakrishnan waited for the game to be over. Calling the little girl, he gently inquired of her, "What's your name, child?" The shy little girl hardly raised her eyes from the ground. "Usha," she whispered and added, "from class 4. Thus was made one of the greatest discoveries in the athletic arena of Asia. A simple question from an observant master and an equally unassuming answer from a tiny village girl from a distant village in Malabar in Kerala. That same evening at 4:15 p.m., Usha heard the magical words for the first time in her life. "On your marks, get set, go." The master had explained to her what to do and why. Confused, but very much aware of the seriousness of the occasion, she ran for her life. The rest is history. In 1975, Usha was 11 years old and was practicing vigorously for the sub-junior district meet, her first ever. With 3 days to go, Usha badly injured her heel while practicing for the long jump. The day of the event, all eyes were on her. She was so puny as unbelievably tiny that she was the crowd's favorite even before the race started. A white bandage on her heel won her even more sympathy. She came first in all the 4 events she participated in, 100 meters, 200 meters, long jump and high jump. She was also the individual champion at the meet. Academically, Usha was an extremely bright student. She was always amongst the top 3 in her class and was popular with her teachers. She passed her standard 7 exams with a first class grade. Just then, the government of Kerala announced a separate sports division for girls at Kannanur, a town with special facilities for sports in addition to regular studies. Usha joined the sports division at Kannanur to improve her sport talent. She was left in the safe hands of C.H. Paital, the headmaster of the school. It was at Kannanur that another great master fired her imagination so much that together they achieved the impossible. His name was Madhavan Nambiar. By 1977, Usha and Nambiar were inseparable. Nambiar had found the ward he had been waiting for all his life, and Usha had found her guru. Nambiar would, from now on, care for her like a father. Usha's meticulous systematic training began in earnest. Usha had regular training run on the beach of Paioli. She preferred to be trained alone, for the vastness of the beach gave her a sense of freedom. She ran joyfully and freely, and she derived her strength from the serenity and peace of her beloved Kerala surroundings. Nambiar introduced his sand training in her program to enhance her performance in the athletics just after the 1982 New Delhi Asian Games. Sand training had enhanced the performance of many great athletes, from Edwin Moses to top flight Indian athletes like Milkha Singh and Sriram Singh. Usha's athletic achievements are well known to almost all Indians. Two silver medals in the 1982 New Delhi Asian Games, fourth place in the 400 meter at the 1984 Jakarta Asian Meet, and four golds and one silver at the 1986 Asian Games in Seoul. P.T. Usha's story is that of a gifted child from humble origins, achieving international success through sheer dedication and immense hard work. Never in the history of independent India has a youngster from a remote background town of rural origin caught the imagination of youth in particular and the public in general as Usha has, said a professor of English in Usha's hometown. Children, listen to the lesson once again and then read on your own. Yeah.